This is Duke University.
I'm Eleanor Caves. I'm a third year PhD candidate at Duke University in the biology department. I study visual ecology, which is the study of relationships between an animal's visual capabilities and its visual needs or visual environment. The two parties in this interaction are the cleaner shrimp and the client fish. So the cleaner shrimp is the one that lives in a set location and will provide cleaning services. The client fish is any species of fish, sometimes we even see eels or even turtles, that comes to the cleaning station and gets cleaning services. So in that interaction, the cleaner will pick parasites, dead skin, scales, mucus off of the client, whatever it is. So I basically wanted to know, okay, so what do these two parties see in this interaction? We already know a lot about fish vision, so I'm able to sort of already answer the question, what does a fish see when it looks at a cleaner shrimp? But no one has ever looked at cleaner shrimp vision. So the question, what does a cleaner shrimp see when it looks at a client fish, is something we couldn't answer. So using a really sensitive probe in the eye, you can shine light of different colors and intensities at the eye, and that can tell you how sensitive the eye is to different colors of light. What I found is that cleaner shrimp are totally colorblind. They actually only have one type of visual pigment, whereas humans have three. So they're completely colorblind. They're seeing the world basically in grayscale. In terms of spatial resolution, we found that it's incredibly coarse. They really can't see detail at all. And in fact, when a fish swims up to a cleaning station, probably all the shrimp is seeing is sort of a blob. They might detect changes in light, but they're really just seeing that something is sort of looming over me, and that's all the detail they can see. That's completely the opposite of what we expected. We're talking about an animal that lives in an environment and interacts with other animals where there's potentially so much information it can gain, so much it can learn, if it can actually perceive color and pattern. And it can't see any of that. By studying animals with small brains, things that perceive the world very differently than we do, I think we can learn a lot about what information is necessary. How does an animal with a small brain actually process information? And for example, with a cleaner shrimp, we might look at the way they perceive the world and think that's bad, there's not good enough, how can they make it with these limited capabilities, but really it's all they need. And once we understand more fully how they're perceiving the world around them, we can start to understand how then is the brain processing this information and how do tiny brains work.
Produced by Duke University.